Hi, this is Pat Johnson, your psychology instructor, and in this mini lecture, we're going to talk about generalization and show generalization by discussing the little Albert experiment. So generalization in classical conditioning is the tendency after conditioning for the subject to respond similarly to stimuli that resemble the conditioned stimulus. So let's suppose that I made a noise, maybe it was a tone, a particular tone, and then I blew a puff of air in your eye, and you blinked. So blinking to the puff of air would be the unconditioned response, the puff of air would be the unconditioned stimulus. And the noise, which used to be neutral, would be the conditioned stimulus, and blinking to that noise would be the conditioned response. So off camera, I have a few goblets, so let me make a noise. And let's suppose that noise was the conditioned stimulus. And then, after I had conditioned you, I came along and made this noise. If you notice, that's a different noise. That's a new noise. If you responded to this noise just like you had to that noise, then we would have generalization. It would be responding similarly to stimuli that resembled the conditioned stimulus. So, who is Little Albert? Little Albert was the son of a woman who worked for two researchers, John Watson and Rosalie Rayner. And what Watson and Rayner wanted to know was, could they classically condition a fear response in an infant? And if you're starting to wonder whether this was unethical, yes, it certainly was. It's very unethical, but it was the 1920s before they had the ethical review procedures and laws that we have today. So what they did is they wanted to see, could we classically condition a fear response? Remember, emotions, vegetative responses, and levels of arousal are three types of responses that can be classically conditioned. And they wanted to see if they could classically condition a fear response in little Albert, who was a very happy-go-lucky little baby. He wasn't afraid of anything. And they wanted to see, could they train him to fear the laboratory rats that he normally liked and played with. So what all infants hate are really loud noises. So here's what they did. They paired that rat, which used to be neutral, with a really loud noise, and little Albert cried. So the loud noise would be the unconditioned stimulus. Crying to the loud noise would be the unconditioned response. And what came right before, because remember, our neutral stimulus, which becomes our conditioned stimulus, this comes first. So the rat used to be neutral, then we pair the rat with the loud noise, and little Albert cried, and pretty soon the rat alone caused little Albert to cry. So the conditioned stimulus leads to a conditioned response. But again, we're talking about generalization. And from our definition, generalization means to respond similarly to stimuli that resemble the conditioned stimulus. So in the little Albert example, the conditioned stimulus is the white rat. So Watson and Rayner wanted to see if they could get little Albert to cry to stimuli that were similar to a white rat. Stimuli that he had never had paired with the U.S., but things that were similar enough to a white rat. So they tested him on a dog. They tested him on a white rabbit. They tested him on a fur coat. And all three of these were similar enough to the white rat that these caused the same conditioned response, even though they had never been paired with the loud noise. And that shows generalization in classical conditioning, again, for a subject to respond similarly to a stimuli similar to the conditioned stimulus.